In this video, we're looking at a photoelectric effect experiment. So we have light rays coming in from the left. Those strike a metal target. If they have enough energy to bump electrons off that metal target, the electrons can travel across this gap to the opposite plate, and a current will be registered by an ammeter in the circuit. Now there's a power source in the circuit, and for the first part of the problem, that's turned off. We're applying 0 volts to this thing, and we're just trying to figure out what's the binding energy of an electron to that metal target, given that the longest wavelength of light that will produce a current is 525 nanometers. So the way to look at it is photons with a wavelength of 525 nanometers, those have the minimum required energy to rip electrons off that metal target. That's called the binding energy of that material. That's also known as the work function. So what we want is the energy of these photons. And at this point, we're used to writing the energy of a photon as hc over lambda. And using these convenient units where hc is approximately 1240 EV nanometers. If you want more precision, you can call that 1242. And the wavelength here was 525 nanometers. The nanometers cancel and I immediately get the energy of the photon. And this is about 2.36 electron volts. So it takes a minimum of 2.36 electron volts just to bump electrons off of that plate. And that's what we call the binding energy for the material. In part B, we're asked to get the stopping potential if we use a higher energy light, 450 nanometers. So that has a smaller wavelength, higher frequency, higher energy. So electrons bumped off by this light are going to carry some kinetic energy with them. And what we do is turn the dial on the power source until we just barely stop any of those electrons from making it to the other side. And that's the cut point where we'll register a current of 0 in the apparatus. So what we want to figure out is how much kinetic energy do these electrons have after they've been ripped off the material? Remember, that takes 2.36 EV of energy just to escape the material. There will be some leftover energy in the kinetic energy of the electron, and then we'll figure out the voltage we need to turn this up to stop an electron with that much energy. So again, we'll start by getting the energy of this photon, hc over lambda, approximately 1240 EV nanometers over the wavelength. This gives us about 2.76 electron volts of energy in this photon. Now the kinetic energy of an electron that absorbs that photon is going to be the energy that was carried in the photon minus the amount that was used to escape the material. That's the binding energy. So we get 2.76 minus 2.36. And this gives us about 0.4 electron volts of kinetic energy. Now the stopping potential just has to be sufficient to absorb all that kinetic energy by the time the electron gets to the other side. So the stopping potential is just the same number. It's 0.4 volts. And this means the electron will gain 0.4 electron volts of potential energy on its way toward the opposite plate, driving the kinetic energy down to 0, and it will stop before it arrives at the other side. If you enjoyed this video or at least found it useful, check out another one by clicking one of the links on the left, or click the Zach's Lab logo on the right to explore dozens of physics and math playlists. As always, you can leave your questions, comments, and requests in the comments section below, and I'll get back to you within 24 hours. Thanks for watching Zach's Lab, and best of luck on your math and physics journey.